Hi guys, so today is the moment like it's like a every dream come true of a Galaxy Grand Prime owner, especially the 530H. Like I used to taunt my mom like your phone doesn't have any mods, no ROMs, because I have a Galaxy S4 which I don't have currently with me, and it has like shit ton of ROMs, but this Grand Prime especially doesn't have it. But now we are going to install CyanogenMod 12.1, which is 5.1.1 Android stock Android CyanogenMod on this Grand Prime 530H. So it took me a lot of tries, like it should be a specific version XU or XXU of your baseband version, because it took a lot of time until build 77 would finally work on my XXU. Your might be XAU, so you can use your old builds because they have some lesser bugs, I guess. But now latest one is like 81 build, which is good. The developer is working very very hard, but let's get into it and flash. So go to recovery by pressing down your power home and volume up. So if you want to see a video on installing the recovery, which is kind of late, like this is a 2014 device, but I will still make a video to show you guys. It's not for me, it's for you. As you can see, we are in the recovery right now. I will leave up a link for this recovery because this is the specific one which only work for this ROM. So let's get into wipe, Dalvik cache, data, cache, system. You don't need to select external storage or micro SD card, we need that, at least me. Swipe to wipe. That was fast. Let's go back. Go to install. Search video downloaded. I must be able to share it. There it is. Unofficial build. So sadly, my internet connection right now has broke down, and I don't have GApps. I can't show you the working version of Google Apps and Play Store. Sorry for that, but I will leave a link in the description. Just download that and flash after flashing this ROM so you can get the Play Store working. Don't just smash down the comment box. And the process is quite fast. It doesn't take time at all. Like in my experience was flashing on Galaxy Tab 4, my Euphoria, which is the slowest one. Also the Galaxy S4, which takes time to install CyanogenMod ROMs, but as you can see, under a minute, which is very very fast compared to the Exynos 54 versus the Snapdragon 14. And just go to the reboot and system. It's like 12 a.m. in the morning and I'm shouting in my house. Sorry for the awkward focus. And the ROM should be booting in a very less time as it very optimized, but there are some bug like in call audio is sometimes missing, also like hotspot is not working, the camera is not working, because in specific regions the modules of the back camera are very very awkward, like both of the modules. I know it's like Sony IMX, but they are very different. And we shall wait. Sometime in this case of my Euphoria, which is also running like CyanogenMod 13, takes a whole lot of time to boot. I don't know why. Both of running CyanogenMod 12.1 and 13. It's like a Resurrection Remix or a custom ROM of the custom ROM, like knockoff or knockoff ROM. Quite a nice boot animation over there. As you can see, it has booted up very fast for first boot. But actually, like holding this device without TouchWiz and running stock Android is very nice experience actually. And I will be doing a review of this ROM, so subscribe to my channel for more Grand Prime videos and you will be appreciated for what you have done, like subscribing to this channel. Sorry if I sound weird because it's like 12 a.m. in the morning. And this also runs Cyanogen, like not Cyanogen, Snapdragon 14, but overclocked version, like 1.9 GHz, which sounds like a behemoth, but not. This 1.2 GHz is actually like raw processing power is better on this Grand Prime. As you can see, very very fast. United States, which is I use. I live in India, of course. And the Wi-Fi is not working, but it is still connected. Because why not? Just a sec. Skip. Skip. Next. No. 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 Next. And we are in the stretch budget, I guess. Okay. And there you have it. CyanogenMod mode 12.1 fully running, and it's very very smooth. As to me, it's like very very smooth. I don't know how to make that thing big. It might be some DPI issue, which could be fixed, of course. And as you can see, this is the smoothest one I have ever experienced, rather than my Galaxy S4, which is a very powerful phone. In that case, let me just focus again. I think this should be good. And let me just show you that we are actually running CyanogenMod 12.1. As you can see, that apps are very optimized. Like if you hit the app, it will just open right away, like iPhones. As you can see, CyanogenMod 12.1. I never thought, like I was just purchasing this in September 2014 and we will be here. Never thought. Like this is a new era for this device. You can't get Marshmallow also. Not the stock one by this CyanogenMod community. Thanks to the Zimba 555, I guess. Sorry for the wrong name. But guys, thanks for watching. As you can see, camera is not working. Subscribe to the channel for more reviews on the Galaxy Grand Prime. Peace.